Thank you. Thank you. Good morning. Welcome everyone here in Las Vegas and everyone around the world following our presentation online. So this is the Archicad 23 official, you know, launch or release presentation. So we are first time showing you Archicad 23 live. But next to Archicad 23, there is going to be lots of other unveilings today. So for the next couple of 70-75 minutes, we have like a whole series of presentations. So let's dive deep in. So any great product development starts with the fine balance in between features, functionality, new capabilities, and making the existing capabilities better functioning, so like performance. To make my point, let me borrow an example from our good friends at Apple. So at the last iPhone update, the camera feature got a huge boost, both in functionality. So adjustable depth control is something that in the previous iPhone you couldn't do. It's a new capability. As well as performance. So it's much better now taking pictures in low light conditions, like, you know, at night. You could take pictures before at night, but it's not much better now. So much better performance. With Archicad 23 and the previous versions, we try and keep this fine balance in between these two areas. And for the new release, we have these three main focus areas along which I will walk you through this morning. Let's start with modeling, which is, I suppose, at the very core of BIM. So you might wonder if after 30 years of development, there's anything new to add as a capability to the BIM tools modeling. To a little surprise, I think there is still, and it's at the core of actually the buildings as well. So the whole architecture started with beams and columns. And this is so fundamental to our profession that any architecture student is first introduced to the architecture proportions at school via learning about, you know, these columns, module, well, system. But evolution hasn't started, so still going on. So there is a big trend going on for quite some time in modern era, which makes us enhance and introduce new capabilities to our beam and column functionality. So what I'm talking about is, you know, buildings are less and less being constructed on site as opposed to assembled in, created in factories and assembled on site. And as I said, it's not a very recent thing, so it started like 50 plus years ago with some dead ends. This is an image from Budapest. We have these panel buildings. But I think the way, the direction the industry is taking now is taking parts of buildings and manufacture, fabricate them in factories, deliver to the sites, and then assemble there. So there are dedicated software solutions to support the manufacturing, but there is no very specific dedicated BIM tool to support the design of these structures. So this is what we would like to show you in Archicad 23 now. So let me invite my colleague Akos Karotskoy, who is happy to show you the new revamped beam and column tool in Archicad.